In this presentation, we will take a look at the calculation of the future value of an annuity. Our information will be up top. We'll enter that information in the blue area down below. Information up top, we have the number of periods, 3, the payments, 100, and the rate is going to be 10%. The periods are going to be in years, and of course, the rate is in terms of years. 3 ways we can do this: 1, with the use of a formula; 2, with the use of the tables; and 3, with the use of Excel functions. So first we're going to start off with the table. So if we were to use the table, we're going to say, all right, the number of payments is going to be payments, and we'll say that is $100. Then we're going to pick up the amount from the table. Now remember, this is going to be an annuity of future value. So we're looking at the future value, and it's often easy to think of an investment type of activity here. So we're putting in 3 payments of $100, and we want to know what it will be valued at that future time period, which will be greater than today's time period. So if we had 3 $100 payments, it's got to be something greater than 300. So we got 3 payments, which would add up to 300. It's got to be something higher than that. So we're going to say, all right, this is going to be 10%. 10% is over here, and then we had 3 payments, so it's going to be this 3.3100. So we're looking at this 3.3100, and that's going to be the future value of an annuity is what we're looking for. And if we multiply that out, then it's going to be the $100 times the 3.3100 for the 331. Now we can also do this with the function in Excel. This is the other way we could do the annuity future value. One way to get there is to go to the formulas up top, and we are in the function library. We want to go to the insert function. Now we're looking for the future value. The same one that we used when we used the future value of 1 is what we'll use now as we calculate the future value of the annuity. This is nice because we only have to memorize this one function for the 2 items. However, we do have to know the difference between them as we do the calculation. So we're going to say OK. Here's going to be our function box that we'll put our formula into. The rate is going to be our 10% in cell B4. That's going to be 10 here. The number of periods is going to be 3. So 3 periods, 3 here. And then the payment is going to be 100. So B4, B2, and B3, we're just picking up our data. Here are the values. It'll give us the result. It's going to represent it in a negative number, 331 here. We'll say OK. If we want to flip the sign to make that positive, I do that by double-clicking on it, going before the F and putting a negative in front of it, in essence saying, hey, take that, multiply times -1, giving us a positive number. To review the formula, you could type it in this format. Equals negative to flip the sign, future value, brackets, and then we'll go through our information, the rate first. That's in B4. So rate B4, comma, to the next field, the number of periods, that is 3 in B2, and then comma to the next field and the payments, that is going to be in B3. Note the difference here of an annuity and if we had a single sum, future value, in which case this would be 0 and we would go to the present value item, which we included. Here it's an annuity, so we're going to use the payment field. Okay, so that's going to be our information. We could also use GoalSeek, and the point here is that if we just know this one function, we can also find the periods or the rate using that function if that's our missing variable. So in other words, if we knew the periods, we didn't know the rate, and we knew the answer was 331 or the future value. Instead of typing 331 here, I'm going to say I want to put the function in here and then ask Excel to change this cell in order to make the function what it should be. So in other words, I'm going to just guess a rate. This is typically how I would do it, at like 0.5 or let's say 5%, and then type in our formula, which is negative future value of the rate, 5%, we guessed, we're going to change that, comma, and then the number of periods is 3, and then comma, and the payments is the 100, and enter. So that gives us our 315. It's wrong because we need to change this percentage. We know what it should be, 331. To do that, we're going to use GoalSeek and say, hey, Excel, would you help us out with this? So we'll go up top, we're going to say data up top. We want to go to forecast and what if analysis, GoalSeek, And then we're going to say, all right, set, we want to set this cell to be what we know that should be, 331. We want to do that by changing the number of the interest rate, I should say. We want to change the interest rate. To do that, that's going to be this cell. So let's go through that again. We're going to say, all right, set this cell, that's here, B19, to be 331 by changing this cell. And we'll say, okay, it changes it. And so now we're at 10% and 331. So here's our answer that we used by putting the formula down here instead of putting the formula up here, because we would have to learn a new formula to do that. So again, we could do that here. If we didn't know the number of periods, we knew the rate and we knew the future value was 331. Instead of typing 331 here and using a formula up top, we're going to say, I know the formula here. Let's do that first and just like guess some periods just to have something up there. Let's say 10. Let's say 11. So we'll say negative future value, double click, the rate, 10%, comma, number of periods, 11. It's wrong. We'll change it using GoalSeek, comma, and then the payment, 100. Enter. This is wrong. It needs to be that. How are we going to change it? GoalSeek. So we'll go up top, data, forecast, what if analysis, GoalSeek. And then we're going to say, hey, Excel, would you change this cell to be what we know it should be, 331, by adjusting this cell? So in other words, one more time, change this cell with the formula in it to 331 by adjusting this cell, the number of periods, the unknown. We'll say, okay. And it does so. So it put 3 years and the 331.